Hi, Tom from Fluval here today. Today we're at head office enjoying the sunshine outdoors. So if you hear some noise in the background or some disturbance, don't pay attention to it because we're out here taking advantage of this beautiful weather here in Montreal. And we have Robert Winkelmeyer here from Pisces Volant. We are going to discuss today a little bit about his marine importation business. Robert is somebody I've known for many, many years. He's a wealth of knowledge when it comes to marine life and about aquatics in general. So we thought it'd be a great thing to bring him on board and talk about his business and how he got into it. All of us that are interested in aquatics, I'm sure, always find that really interesting. I know for sure I do. So Robert, nice to have you here today. Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
We'd like to know, I guess, right off the bat, how did you get into fish keeping in general?
Well, my first tank I got when I was about 8 or 9 years old. It was a birthday present, and I've always been fascinated by aquatic life. So I had in that tank, I had some newts and fish too. I had a goldfish and an African frog and things like that. 5.5 gallon tank, kit, Hagen tank actually. That was a great present. I liked it for many years, and then built up on that. I think it starts out with one tank. And if you really like it, you keep on adding tanks.
Yep, sounds exactly like my story, actually. So when and how did you turn this passion for fish keeping and your interest in ornamental fish, when and how did you turn that into a business?
I went to school and studied other subjects. I studied graphic design and always came back to aquatics, and always came back to my part-time job that I had during school. And when I graduated and found that I didn't like the field that I was in, I went back on and went and worked with fish again, full time. Right. And after so many years of experience, started up my own business.
Okay, interesting. Mm-hmm. Take us through a typical day at Pisces Volant. What is it like when you open up the key first thing in the morning? What happens?
Well, we start pretty early in the morning because we're wholesale and all our customers are retailers. So we're basically packing up livestock and delivering it to stores. And we start our day normally at about 7:30 in the morning. Sometimes earlier, sometimes as early as 4:30 in the morning, depending on how many orders we have to pack. And basically we want to get them all out by a reasonable hour, so the stores have time to unpack, because nobody wants to receive fish at 5 p.m. in the afternoon before they're gonna, go home.
Exactly.
So we pack up fish, and the other thing that we do is we take care and maintain the fish. We have to have time for maintenance. The aquariums have to be cleaned constantly. The filtration has to be maintained. The fish have to be fed. They're fed a very good diet. We have to check on the health of the fish, especially fish that are newly imported. So that fills up our day. And then sometimes the day goes on. When we're receiving fish, typically they arrive at 3:30 or 4 o'clock in the afternoon by plane. And so we can be unpacking until 8 p.m., 9 p.m., 10 p.m. at night. So sometimes we have very long days.
Okay.
Yeah.
And kind of what takes place from the point that you're ordering fish, when you place an order for fish from your overseas suppliers, to the point that they get to the actual premises, how much time elapses, what are your procedures for acclimating them, and to the point that you ship them out again? Like, kind of just give us a broad flow through overview of what happens.
Well, we have different types of suppliers. Some are catch to order and some have inventory. So catch to order, basically we are placing an order for fish, for invertebrates, corals, and they go and get them and then they ship to us. So that typically takes a few days more than ordering out of somebody's inventory. The advantage of catch to order is that the fish aren't handled very long. They're not kept in tanks for very long before you receive them. So the chances of receiving fish that have diseases or problems are very low. Basically, the supplier has to be capable in the way that they can diagnose if the fish are sick or healthy, and therefore hold them back if they're not in good enough condition to ship, and they can be re-released in the wild or whatever they do with them over there.
Okay.
So
that's an interesting point of differentiation between the two groups of fish the way you would order them, you know, catch to order or stuff out of inventory. So when they get to here in Montreal, what's your typical procedure? The fish are unpacked right away.
Yeah.
They're acclimated. Generally, they go right into the tanks, or do you take your more time with certain fish? Or?
Well, every fish comes from a different country.
Yeah.
All of these different countries are different distances from Montreal. So when the fish come from further away, the pH in the bags is typically much lower. The pH can be as low as 6 in the bags. So the fish have to be acclimated over a longer period of time, depending on how long they've been in transit.
Okay.
Fish that have been in transit for a very short period of time, like less than 24 hours, they can be acclimated in a space of an hour, like a normal purchase that somebody would make at a pet store.
Right. Okay.
But the other fish require a special acclimating, and then we usually do not sell them for a few days because we want to observe them. Certain animals can be shipped out as soon as they're imported, such as certain types of corals and certain really, really hardy invertebrates and things like that. But most of the fish require a day of rest or two.
Yeah, okay.
So, and sometimes longer. Some fish take 3 or 4 days or a week before they're eating properly and before they're acclimated properly, that they can be sold to somebody.
Well, it's good to hear that you pay attention to things like that. It's very important, I think, for anybody to know. The care and the amount of detail that goes into this. So just to top finish things off, what are some of the countries or regions that you more prefer to order from versus others, or any preferences or dislikes you may have?
Personal preferences? Well, I like
business related.
I like larger fish, so I really like importing from Sri Lanka.
Okay.
Yeah. I like Sri Lankan fish, I like Hawaiian fish, I like the larger fish because maybe because my eyesight isn't so good anymore and they're more fun to unpack. I like, you know, bigger fish.
Okay.
Some of the smaller fish that we get in, you know, like little gobies and blennies and things like that, they're cute and everything, but, you know, it's all a matter of personal preference, I guess.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, thanks a lot, Robert. That's been very insightful. We hope you've enjoyed this little bit of a look inside of a marine importation business. Tom from Fluval Aquatics saying thanks for watching, and make sure to tune in at fluvalaquatics.com to see more videos upcoming.